Hey guys, what's up and welcome to a new video. So today I'm gonna show you how to build a super cool plasma flame generator step by step. I made a collaboration with Jay from Plasma Channel and please check out his video about the plasma flame generator because in my opinion he built the most beautiful plasma flame generator on earth. Usually most people are using such big tubes for generating plasma flames. But that's easy. We can do it with MOSFETs. I will now show you how to build this super cool plasma flame generator which can produce a 4 cm flame step by step. So my friends, it's very important if you want to rebuild this, you have to use exactly the same part values as I did, otherwise it will not work. Here you can see the circuit of the plasma flame generator. You will need 3 different coils, 1 MOSFET, 3 capacitors, 2 diodes, 2 resistors and 1 potentiometer. So all in all it looks pretty easy. But my friends, you can ask Jay, this circuit is definitely not so easy how it looks. The problem is tuning, but when you do it exactly like I did, it's pretty easy. So let's start with the build. I will now give you a small overview of the components. The resonator is nearly the most important part of our circuit because this resonator creates the high voltage output. The resonator needs a resonance frequency of 10 MHz. You can make, for example, a coil like I did on a 2.5 cm tube with 150 turns and 0.6 mm wire. That's around about 10 MHz. A stainless steel breakout point is a pretty good idea. This is a primary coil on a 5.5 cm tube with 5.5 turns and 1.3 mm wire. This coil needs an inductance of 10 microhenry. You can make, for example, a coil on a 1.5 cm tube with 17 turns and 0.5 mm wire. The RIFP260 is the best MOSFET you can use for the plasma flame generator. You can also use 3 lug connectors because then it's pretty easy to remove a dead MOSFET. When you use a heatsink, the MOSFET will love you. This is a primary capacitor and it's very important that it has a capacity of 100 picofarad. And it's also very important that this capacitor can handle with 2 kV AC minimum. You can use, for example, a ceramic capacitor like I did. Or you can build a small MMC multi-mini capacitor like Jay did. It's very important that the knob of the 10 kilo ohm potentiometer is isolated, otherwise you can get burned. The 1 kilo ohm resistors need a power of 2 watts. The 12 volt xenodiode can also be a 15 volt xenodiode with 0.5 watts. The 15 volt TVS diode is not necessary, but you can save the gate with it. Please use for the 4.7 nanofarad capacitor a film capacitor, not a ceramic capacitor. It's very important that the electrolytic capacitor with 10 microfarad can handle with 400 volts, otherwise it could happen. Okay guys, now we are ready with talking about the components, let's start soldering. First, mount the MOSFET on the heatsink. And if you like, you can add the lug connectors. Now we need 3 thicker copper wires which are not isolated. Connect the copper wire with the lug connector or you can solder them directly to the MOSFET. Now solder the 4.7 nano capacitor between pin 1 and pin 3 of the MOSFET. Then connect the TVS diode also with pin 1 and pin 3. The direction is not important because this diode is bidirectional. Connect the right leg of the potentiometer with pin 3 of the MOSFET. Then place 1 1 kilo ohm resistor between pin 1 of the MOSFET and pin 2 of the potentiometer. After that, solder the xenodiode between pin 1 of the potentiometer and pin 3 of the potentiometer, and it's very important that you beware the direction. Then connect the negative side of the capacitor with pin 3 of the MOSFET. Direction is important. If you have done this, place a 1 kilo ohm resistor between pin 3 of the potentiometer and the positive side of the capacitor. If you like, you can add a thicker copper wire which is not isolated to the positive side of the capacitor because this is our plus. Connect one end of the coil to plus and the other end of the coil to pin 2 of the MOSFET. Then connect one end of the 100 picofarad capacitor with pin 1 of the MOSFET and the other end with the upper end of the primary coil. Last but not least, connect the lower end of the primary coil with pin 2 of the MOSFET. And now we're done with our oscillator, and yes, this oscillator will work without a resonator. So let's do some tests. Before you apply a voltage to the oscillator, turn the potentiometer completely to the left side. Plus is the positive side of the electrolytic capacitor, and minus is the negative side of the electrolytic capacitor. Now start rotating the potentiometer to the right side. Stop at the point where you see there is a current flow. Now the oscillator oscillates with 10 MHz. Let's do some wireless energy experiments. So guys, that was very impressive, but now we want to create plasma flames. We are just one step away from it. We only have to solder the lower end of the resonator to the connection between primary coil and capacitor. Now the resonator is ready to be excited. So guys, did you expect this? The power of the plasma flame generated at the end of the video was about 500 watts, so 480 watts, 60 volts and 8 amps. Could you imagine that this small MOSFET can handle with so much power? That's absolutely incredible. Why this is possible, I will explain you in Jay's video, so check out his channel. So guys, let's come to an end. I hope you really enjoyed this video. Please like this video, subscribe my channel, and then we will see us in the next project.